Hey, good evening and welcome to the stream. We're here on the Depot Plus server tonight with the high priority mix manifest H mod bar. Point of origin was Modesto, California. We're bound for Barstow. Some custom orders on here. 7,300 feet, almost 7,400 feet. We'll have to pick up some extra locomotives in BNSF Bakersfield. And maybe even a few cars. So there's no dispatcher on this evening, so we go ahead and grab ourselves a signal. And a big thank you to Sydney Selkick there. Thanks for the follow, and hope you enjoy the streams. We're currently on the BNSF Bakersfield sub, about 50 miles, because that'd be west, railroad west of BNSF Bakersfield, so it's going to be probably about an hour or less to get down to Bakersfield. Having a quick look at the dispatcher's board this evening, it doesn't look like we'll be seeing much in the means of AI traffic up in this direction. But that could always change. Clear signal there at 737. 937, rather, sorry. making sure we haven't fallen asleep or died or something. Clear signal. That'll be the distant signal to Allensworth. BNSF 7479 East has a clear signal. CP Allensworth, main track out. that'll be our distant signal to Sandrini.
Detector, milepost 926.5.
BNSF 7479 East has a clear signal at and through Sandrini. Main track out.
BNSF detector, milepost 926.5. No defects. Repeat, no defects. Total axle 512. Train speed 3.4 mph. Temperature 5.5 degrees out.
And no defects on the detectors. Or train passed one defect detector, no issues. See if we can get past the other ones. See how far we get this evening as well. And clear signal. And BNSF 7479 East is a clear signal at East Elmo, main track out. clear signal West Elmo, or East Elmo, rather. And clear signal, mile 9 was a 915.2. at BNSF 7479 East has a clear signal at and through Wasco. Main track out. And clear signal. SF 7479 East. Clear signal. East Shafter. Main track. Out. BNSF 7479 East, clear signal, Shafter crossover, clear signal, leaving West Shafter, out. Thank you.
detector, milepost 900.0, temperature 54 degrees.
And just get a quick save of our train here to feed into we call the power desk here on Depot Plus. Allows me to upload the train and tell me how many locomotives on lead and where I should put them. It's not entirely accurate, but it is a good guide. advanced speed signs for trains. We're maxed at a 55, but if we were passing through, we could get up to 70 in about 2 miles. BNSF 7479 East has an approach medium signal to CP Lopez. Out. So what that means is we're now limited to, we're supposed to slow down to 40 miles an hour. And approaching the next signal, which will be a diverging approach, which the speed limit past that signal will be 30. The idea being, gives us some time to, the signals will give us time and let us know what they are expecting the next light to be. You'll never come across a clear and then go straight to a red signal. There's no way you could stop a train like that. That's going to be in a diverging approach signal. So the signal after that will be an approach, and then either a, well, on the lookout at the signal after that for a stop signal, or maybe something less restrictive, but definitely proceeding on the thought that it will be stop, just in case we actually have to. And BNSF 7479 East, the Virgin Approach medium signal, CP Lopez. Out. BNSF 7479 East, approach restricting, CP Jastro, main 2, I believe. Main 2? Mm-hmm. That signal indicates that our next signal is going to be restricting, which will mean we'll have to slow to 15 miles an hour maximum on the lookout for other trains, any railroad equipment that may be out fouling the main or generally in our way, bad switches, and broken rail. But broken rail is not really simulated in this in run 8 here, so that won't actually be an issue. My plan is at this point to pull into Bakersfield up the, I believe it's the work, the valley lead. And then we're going to go down track 4 and see what there is for power to add to our train. We're going to have to bring it up to a minimum of 2.3 HPT to go over the UP Mojave sub, otherwise we're not going to make it. And right now we're only 1.1, the power desk. Teams have calculated that we're going to need 4 more locomotives, 2 more on the head end and 2 on the back. And that'll be a restricting signal at CP Gomez. The bottom aspect is lit with restricting, which tells us that the one of the switches up in the upcoming signal block here will be aligned for us to go into Barstow, or pardon me, to Bakersfield. It'll actually be the second one. Or it should be, anyways. Like we're gonna have a bad switch up here, we'll have to stop and get. Yeah, it looks like the next switch is already lined for departure 4, so we'll just pull in. So just quickly doing some math with the numbers we have. If I pick up 4 locomotives, that'll add about 292 feet to the train. I'll leave room for another 4 cars we can pick up, because we've got to stay under 8,000 feet for the UP Mojave sub. But that could also throw off our weight calculations on how much power we need. So what I've done is I've counted back 10 cars from my lead locomotives. The rule, as it was explained to me, is the first 10 cars are supposed to be loaded directly behind the power, and it looks like the four cars I'm going to pick up on the neighboring track are going to be empties. So to stay rules compliant, I've made my cut where I did. We'll clear this switch here, back up, tie on, and grab four. A little under 1,000 feet to go to a stop. We'll tie on the locomotives on the rear end and update our paperwork. Well, I guess given the fuel level, it's a good thing this locomotive is only going as far as Barstow. So adding four cars and four locomotives, we are now up to the HP, or over the HPT minimums for the UP Mojave sub, and we actually had about 87 more feet. We probably could have tacked on one more car, but we're a pretty big train as it is. Do a couple of things and do a brake test when the flow on the air brakes comes down, and then we'll be on our way. Do a brake set here, set it up to 70 pounds, wait for the brake pipe in the rear end of the train to come down. That'll tell us we got a good test. Yeah, that's a good test.
UP detector milepost 318.8 1.
No defects.
Thank you.
was, we're just signal we just passed was actually an approach diverging. The previous double yellow signal we passed was on BNSF. We're now in the UP, which is some slightly different rules. And being that it is now almost 1 a.m., I'm going to take the next switch and find a convenient location to park my train. As I was saying earlier, the signals sort of infer what the next one will, what the next indication will be. We passed the previous one. It was a, what was that, approach diverging? This will be a diverging approach medium, I believe. Diverging advanced approach, which means that the next signal after it will be a approach, and then we'll have a stop signal. approach. Well, with that, it's a little after 1 a.m. my time. I'm going to call it a night here. Hope everybody enjoyed the stream. No matter where you are in the world, you have to deal with this quarantine or anything else that's going on. Don't worry too much about it. It can't last forever. Just take best care of yourself as you can and people around you. And hopefully see you in another stream. And thanks for joining, and have a good one.